Did you know that if you close a tab by mistake in Google Chrome, you can quickly open it back up by going to History and looking at the recently closed tabs? And alternatively, there's actually a keyboard shortcut. On Windows, you're going to use the Control key. On Mac, you're going to use the Command key. You're going to press Command, Shift, and T, and you'll notice that the tab that you closed will open right back up. Hi everyone, this is Anson from AnsonAlex.com, and in this video, I'm going to show you my top 5 hidden features of Google Chrome. The first one that I want to talk about is using Inspector. This is how we can gain insight into a web page and actually look at its source code. So to do that, from any web page, you're just going to right-click on the web page and select Inspect from the menu. You'll notice that a window pops up to the right and we can see all of the code for this web page. Now, as I move my mouse over the code, you'll notice that the different elements of the web page that we're looking at are highlighted. Now, I can actually change the code, and it will appear over here on the web page as well. But first of all, I want to show you that if you go to the top left of Inspector, you can click on this icon, which is the arrow with the window, and then you can move over to the page, and you can actually select particular elements on the page, and it will highlight that element in the code. So for instance, let's say I wanted to show this web page to somebody. I don't have an ad blocker installed, and so I just wanted to remove this ad when I show it. I could find the top level div that this ad is in. It looks like it's here in this vlog ad div, and I could click on it over here in Inspector and then hit delete, and you'll notice that that now disappears from this page. This isn't a permanent change, nobody else is going to see it, but on my screen that's what you see. So I can even do things like changing the color of stuff. So if I select this div right here and I look down and you see the background color, I could change this to say white. You'll notice that it changes on the web page itself. So this is great if you're doing web design, because you can come in here to Inspector and you can make changes and see what they would look like. It's also really good for, say, hacking. If you ever wanted to be a hacker, guess where you're going to start? You're going to come in here into Google Chrome Inspector, and you're going to use these different areas within Inspector, like console and the sources area. I'm not going to show you how to hack, but I'm just letting you know that this is where it begins. And hey, have you ever been to a news website where they have that pop up that says, hey, you have to subscribe, you've already hit your maximum amount of views a month? Well, I'm not going to show you exactly, but I will tell you that you can get rid of those paywalls using Inspector just by deleting some elements on the page. Anyways, let's move to my second hidden feature of Google Chrome, and that is using the experimental features in Google Chrome. So I'm going to close out Inspector, and we're going to access the experimental features by opening up a new tab, and we're going to type Chrome colon /, and then flags, just like that. And you'll notice that we are brought to this area in Google Chrome that is experimental. And if you start scrolling, look at my scroll bar on the right side of the screen. There are a lot of experimental options in here. I'm obviously not going to go through all of them. I do have one that you might want to check out on your own. So let's go ahead and search for it. It's called Auto Dark Mode. So I'm just going to search for Auto and then Dark. You'll notice that we have this option to enable auto dark mode for web contents. So this will automatically render all web contents using a dark theme. So you can go ahead and you can go over here to the right and you could enable this feature. And then you'll notice that the next time you launch Chrome, it will take effect. Let's try it out. Okay, so Chrome has relaunched, and you'll notice that right away we see here in the experimental page that the background is black. Let's go to my website. Oh wow, look at that. It completely changed it to dark mode. I will say this will save power on your computer, so this actually is useful other than for aesthetic purposes. If you have a laptop and you're going to be surfing the web a lot and you need to use your battery, you could enable auto dark mode for web contents and you could save some battery because your display is not going to use as much energy. I'm going to disable this for now though, so we'll just go back to default and we'll relaunch Chrome again. Okay, here we are, back in Google Chrome. Now, the next thing that I want to show you is about using multiple tabs here in Google Chrome. I'm talking about actually managing these tabs. So let's go ahead and let's open up another tab. We'll just search for my YouTube channel. We'll just open that up so that we have it. Now, let's say that obviously you can move tabs, right? So I can click on this tab and move it around. So let's move this to the beginning. We'll close this and move my website to the beginning. And let's say, hey, you know, these are two of my web properties. I want to group them together. Well, what I can do is I can actually have one tab open, and then I can hold the Control key on Windows or Command key on Mac, and I can select another tab. And I could select as many as I want as well. And you'll notice that these two tabs are now kind of a lighter color than these two because these are the two I have selected. So now I can right click on either of these two tabs, and you'll notice that I have a number of different options. So first of all, I can add these tabs to a group. So when I do that, you'll notice that these tabs are grouped together. And if I go over here all the way to the left where we have this symbol, I can click on it to collapse that group, and I could click on it to open that group back up. If I right click on it, I'm brought to this little dropdown, which we just saw a second ago and I kind of ignored, but this is where I could name it. So I could just call this like Ants and Alex, and I could give it a blue color since that's kind of the theme that I'm using right now. And then I can go ahead and, like I said, I can click on this and it collapses that tab group so that I could continue working out here and say, oh, I need to go check something. I can go back to this tab group and I can open it up. You can move tab groups around. So notice that I'm moving it on the other side of these tabs. So this is very, very useful. In fact, this almost removes the need to use so many multiple windows when you're using a web browser. So I'm starting to use these tab groups, but you can do a lot of different things. Let's say I wanted to do something else. I could select this tab, and then I could select this tab as well. Then I could right click. You'll notice that I can pin these tabs as well. So if I hit pin, you'll notice that they get small, so because they're going to always be at the top of my web browser, but now they're always over here. So even if I were to close this window or quit out of Chrome, when I open it back up, these pinned tabs would be here. And I could just right click on them to unpin them, and it just opens it back up, allowing me to close it if I wanted to. So that is how you can select and use multiple tabs in Google Chrome. Very powerful feature. The fourth hidden feature of Google Chrome that maybe isn't as hidden, but it's a really cool feature and I want to show you, is using casting in Google Chrome. So here we are. Let's say we're on YouTube, and let's go ahead and let's just open this video right up. Now you can cast here in Google Chrome by going up here to the three little dots at the top right. And you notice that we have this cast option. So we can cast video or audio. The devices that we want to cast to need to be on the same network as our computer. But when I click cast, you'll notice that I have these options to cast the audio to my speaker. So if I choose office speaker, we would hear it play next to me here on my speaker. So this is a great way to watch YouTube. If you have a sound system in your office or wherever you're watching YouTube, you could just cast Chrome to those speakers and you could get a higher quality audio. If I had my TV turned on, you would notice it listed here as well, and I would be able to broadcast or cast this YouTube video to my TV. And for the fifth hidden feature that I'd like to show you in Google Chrome is really a group of features. It's actually the keyboard shortcuts that I find most useful when using Google Chrome. So it's going to be quite a few of them, and I have a list at the end to show you. And I just want to say that I'm going to use Control and Command interchangeably. So if you're on a Mac, you're using the Command key. If you're on a Windows, you're using the Control key. No matter what I say, there is one shortcut where it is a little bit different, and I will explain that. So my top keyboard shortcut is Command or Control R to just refresh the page. We're starting simple here, right? Now from here, I also like the Command or Control F shortcut. You'll notice that when I do that, I get a search box that pops up here at the top right, and then I can search this page. It highlights the text that matches my search, and I can click the arrows to go through the page and find all of those search terms. I use this one every day when I'm on a web page. It's a long page. Articles are really long on the internet nowadays. I only want to find a specific thing. Command F, Control F, and search that page. The next one is Command or Control T, simply opens a new tab, another one that I use all day long. Command or Control W will close the current tab that you're looking at. If you want to open a new window in Chrome, you're going to press Command or Control N to open up that new window. If you want to close that window, you can press Command or Control, then Shift and W, and it will close that window for you. If you want to minimize your window, you're going to press Command or Control M, and you'll notice that that window is now minimized. If you want to go to the next tab in your browser, you're just going to press Control and Tab. And Mac users, I actually mean Control for this one. So on Windows and Mac, it's Control, hold down Control, and then press Tab to go through your different tabs. If you press Command Tab on a Mac, you're going to see your application switcher. So that's why it's different. If you want to go backwards through your tabs on Windows or Mac, it's Control, Shift, and then Tab, and you can go backwards through your tabs. And then finally, one of my new favorites that I'm trying to get used to because it's very useful for me is when you're on a web page and say, okay, I'm done reading this web page. I want to go somewhere else. You can press Command or Control L and it brings you right up to your address bar where you can start typing another website so you can navigate as quickly as possible. Here is a list of all the keyboard shortcuts that I just went over in Google Chrome. I'm going to publish this list to my website in the coming days, so stay tuned for that. And there you have it. Those are my 5 most useful hidden features of Google Chrome. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. And if you want to see more technology tips and tutorials, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. That's all I have for you for now. This is Anson from AnsonAlex.com.